Hi everyone, I'm back again with another tutorial. In this video, I'm going to be making a peplum dress. I'll be using 2 meters of fabric. So, let's get started. This is my fabric. So you fold your fabric into two. And fold it again. So what we're going to do next is to take the measurement. For the neck, I'm taking 4 inches here. And the downside, that is the depth, 4 inches as well. So you draw the line together. And the shoulder, I'm taking 4 inches. Let's say 5 inches with similar ones. This is the shoulder. So next is for me to take the bust, measurement. From my shoulder to my bust is 10 inches. From shoulder to bust is 10. And this is where I'll place the bust measurement. So bust measurement is 41. Then plus seam allowance. So I'll be taking 11. The bust measurement is 41 plus seam allowance, so I'll be taking about 44 inches. So you divide it by 4. If you divide it by 4, because I folded my fabric into 4, so that will give you 11. So this is where you place your bust measurement, 11. And the armhole, I'm going to be making it 9 inches from my shoulder to here. This is where the armhole is. Make a curve, make sure it's round. And at the shoulder, you make a slope here, about 1 inch. So next is to take the waist measurement. The waist measurement is 36 plus 4 inches, that is 40. I'll be taking 4 inches for the waist measurement. So from my bust to my waist is 8 inches. So this is from bust, the distance between my bust and waist is 8 inches. So this is where I'll be placing the bust, the waist measurement. The waist measurement is 36 plus 4, that is 40. You divide by 4, then you get 10 inches. So, here's the inches. So, from my waist to my hip is 9 inches. So, this is 9 inches. And this is where you place your hip measurement. And the hip measurement is 46 plus 4 inches for seam allowance, that is 50. You divide by 4 and I get 3.5. So you make sure you draw the lines together, you connect the line from your armhole down to the waist. From the waist and down to your hip. I'm sorry. So the length of my dress is 32. So this is the first part of the dress. So after this, I'm gonna cut it out. And after this, then we'll make the peplum, that's the flare. So this is how it should look. This is the first part of this dress. So we're going to cut the tampa, that is the flare, the peplum. So to cut out the flare, you have to fold your fabric again into two. Fold your fabric like so. For the length of the peplum, I'll be making it 9 inches. On the top here, I'll be cutting out 4. So this is the peplum. So I'll be separating it now. This is the front. And the back, I have to cut it into two. That is where we insert the zip. You fold it like so. So we are cutting out the sleeve. So the length of the sleeve, I'll be making it about 8 inches. 8 inches means a short sleeve. The armhole is 9, so I have to make sure everything is accurate. So this is 9. This is where I make my sleeve. You can use a usual top to cut the sleeve out if you don't know how to make the sleeve. Any top you have. To cut it out. So this is the sleeve, and I will use this to cut the other side. So what we're going to do next is to join your fabric to put everything together. Like I said earlier, this is the back panel. This is where the zip is going. The front. And this is the sleeve. This is the flare, that is the peplum. at the bottom. So what I'm going to do now is to stitch this side, both sides, the shoulder, stitch the shoulder, you stitch both sides, then you fix in your peplum, your sleeve and hem your neck. So it's finished. Don't forget you have to add your zip. But this is stretchy fabric. You can still use it without adding a zip to it.